Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can get started with React. To learn React.js, we need to have good knowledge in HTML and JavaScript. And some basic knowledge in CSS is also good. I'm sure you are good in HTML. But if you are new to web development and if you are not having knowledge in HTML, I suggest you to make use of this video to learn HTML. We know React is a JavaScript library. So JavaScript knowledge is very important to learn React, especially ES6 in React. We use many ES6 features in React. I have a separate playlist called JavaScript 0 to Hero, which covers all basic concepts, and another one for advanced concepts called JavaScript Hero to Superhero. If you are not having good knowledge on JavaScript, I suggest you to make use of these playlists. Even I have explained about the ES6 concepts as part of the basic concept series. And even without CSS knowledge, you can learn React.js. But learning CSS adds a good value to your React career. So you can use this CSS 0 to Hero series to get good understanding on CSS. Even you can see this playlist after learning React. So we have seen what are all the skills needed to start learning React. Let's also see what are all the softwares we need. First, we need Node.js. Node.js is the platform needed for the React.js development. In Node.js, we have NPM, which is Node Package Manager. Using NPM, we can install the dependencies easily. And there is something called NPX, which is Node Package Execute. This comes with the NPM. Using NPX, we can easily execute the Create React app, which is a comfortable environment for creating a React application. So let's install Node.js. We can go to this official Node.js website to install Node.js. We can use this one, which is recommended. This will download a MSI file. We need to open that file to start the installation process. But I'm going to use one of the previous versions I have downloaded before, because I don't want this latest version, which may affect some of my Angular projects running in this system. Okay. We just need to follow the on-screen instruction to complete the installation. Node.js has been installed. To verify whether Node.js has successfully installed in our machine, we need to open a command prompt and then type node space hyphen hyphen version and then press enter. This will display the version of node installed in our machine. Also, we can use npm space hyphen hyphen version to see the version of npm installed. In your machine, these versions may be different. If it is not displaying the version and showing some error, that means Node.js is not installed correctly. You need to find the root cause and reinstall Node.js. Okay, next we need an IDE. There are many IDEs. I am using Visual Studio Code, which is free. You can go to this website to download and install VS Code. Now we are all set to start learning React. But before that, I have told React is good for developing single page applications. So I need to explain first what is a single page application and how it is different from a traditional web application. Let's take a traditional web application. In this, when I navigate from one page to another, we can see the page is getting refreshed. We can see in View Source page, the entire content is getting changed. That is because in a traditional web application, when we go to a new page, the client, which is our browser, that requests the server to serve the new page. And the server gives back the new page HTML as response. And then browser displays that. And so there will be network traffic between client and server on every page navigation. Assume we have clicked a link to navigate to a new page. And if there is a network problem, and so client is taking some time to communicate to the server. In that case, our page will be keep on waiting for the response. In traditional web applications, we may have multiple HTML files, one for each page. But in single page applications, there will be only one HTML file that will be served when the application is loaded. And when we try to navigate to a new page, there will not be any request from client to server. Instead, there is something called router module, which takes care of navigation. Using JavaScript that hides and shows the needed information. So we can see we are seeing the new page without any delay. It appears to be a multi-page application but actually it is a single page application. Hope you understood the difference between a traditional web application and a single page application. Okay, now let's create our first React application. First, we need to open a command prompt and we can navigate to a folder in which we are planning to create the application. And we can use this command to create the React application. npx space create react app space and a name for the application. Let me give it as my first React app and then enter. We can see our application is getting created. It usually takes some time to create. And it is created now. Let me get into the project folder. And I can use npm start command to start the application. We can see it is starting the development server. And it has started in port 3000. Now we can see it has opened a new tab in the browser and showing our application. So we have successfully created our first React application. Let me show you the project folder. Here we can see some files. So in the next video, I'm going to explain about the use of each file and I'm going to explain you how your React application is actually working. Okay, that's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.